Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Spiffing Brit, and today you join me in the wonderful world of Cookie Clicker. That's right, it's the legendary browser-based game, which I'm sure all of you will remember fondly from back in 2013. Oh my goodness, that's almost a decade ago. Oh God. There are human beings alive today who weren't even born before Cookie Clicker was released. That's a crazy stat. I hope you feel old now. Well, today we're going to be trying to speedrun the entirety of Cookie Clicker and get through it as fast as possible. You see, there are many ways to speedrun just about everything. You can speedrun video games by glitching them. You can speedrun life by smoking 70 cigarettes a day. Anything is possible, as so naturally a professional speedrunner and game exploiter like myself would absolutely love to see if we can correctly speedrun Cookie Clicker. Now, here is the game. It's pretty simple. We can create ourselves a nice little bakery. We'll call it the Spiffco Nightmares Bakery. Now, Cookie Clicker is a very simple game. I click this cookie, I get a cookie, I can then spend it on upgrades. Nice and simple. There we go, one cookie, job done. But of course, if you click the cookie faster, you get more cookies. And wa-bam, there we go, automation can now commence. We now get automatically 0.1 cookie per second. Is this good? No. But when it comes to speedrunning, we're going to do something very different. You see, I want to see just how fast we can get cookies, and I want to get them quickly. Normal people, when speedrunning the game, just try and rush to 1 million cookies. And sure, that's an okay speedrun, good for them. The only issue is it's heavily RNG-based, because you're effectively waiting for a golden cookie to arrive and give you a gigantic speed boost. And as fun as it would be to have 100 runs, where we just wait for these lovely golden cookies to appear and give us, oh, plus increased clicking power for 77 seconds, so that we can break a speedrun. Actually, oh my god, we might actually be able to do it. We might actually accidentally speedrun this. There's no way. Oh no. See, there was a chance. There was a chance. We got actually the correct golden cookie that you need in order to speedrun the game. And we got it instantaneously. We could have broken a world record though if I'd done that correctly, because the world record is like 6 minutes. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Well, that's fine. We're not here to break the world record for Cookie Clicker. Instead, we're here to try and set some records of our own. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you sat back, relaxed, you have a nice warm cup of tea in front of you, and you're ready to dunk potentially millions of cookies into it. Now, without further ado, let's dive into attempt one of trying to speedrun Cookie Clicker. Right, welcome to factory number one. It's going to be our first attempt, and so what I've done is I've loaded my standard auto clicker onto my mouse, and I'm going to simply hold down and click as much as possible, and we'll see how well we can do. Now, as you can see, we're able to make a decent quantity of cookies per second. It's not that bad. Pretty decent indeed. I'd kind of like it to be faster, but already we can buy ourselves some cursors and some grandmas. So there we go, we'll pick up our first grandma. They can bake one cookie per second, which is fantastic, but I am noticing one issue. I'm having to hold down my mouse button here, and I'm not exactly gaining that many cookies per second. What if instead of using just one auto clicker, I loaded multiple auto clickers all at once? Because if we have 5 auto clickers running simultaneously, all pressing the exact same spot, then logically we could get cookies faster. So let's scrap attempt one immediately and get attempt two going. Right, welcome to attempt 2. What I've done now is I've opened up 4 separate auto-clicker systems, and I've told each of them to click 50,000 times per second. Now, be warned, if you're trying to do this at home, most browsers can't handle this, and most PCs probably can't handle this. It'll just crash. Luckily, I'm using
Netscape Navigator,
because I use it for all my most intense things, and so we should be able to survive. There might be a little bit of lag, but running all of these programs simultaneously to absolutely decimate the mouse button should hopefully yield decent results. Oh dear, oh dear, right. This is either going to explode my computer, or it's going to make us a lot of cookies. 3, 2, 1, blast off! And this is pretty much the same. I mean, I'm watching my PC specs and there's a lot of intense RAM and such, but I'm noticing that actually we're not gaining cookies any faster than attempt 1. Hang on a second, what's going on, game?
A few moments later.
Okay, after doing some research, I've discovered that actually Cookie Clicker has an anti-auto-clicker system in place, although it was added mostly to stop people's browsers from crashing when they used auto-clickers, not as an anti-cheating method. Basically, there has to be a gap of 4 milliseconds between each individual click, otherwise a cookie simply won't be counted. So you could click that cookie 100 times in a span of 4 milliseconds, but it's only going to count as one cookie. This creates a problem, because it basically means our auto-clicking is capped. We can't take our auto-clicking anywhere beyond just one click every 4 milliseconds. So that means if we can't speed up the auto-clicking process, what process can we speed up? And this is where we're going to start completely and utterly removing the human element with the use of macros, ladies and gentlemen. I don't think this is the way the game was actually designed to be played, but honestly, I could play it whatever way I like, okay? The rules of the internet are mine. Todd Howard said I could play with it, so that's what we're doing today. So when I say we're getting rid of the human element, I mean we're basically no longer going to be playing the game. And the reasoning is simple. Humans are slow. Well, most of you guys are. I, however, manage to drink 700,000 cups of tea per second, and consequently can move 5 times the speed of light, which naturally means, sadly, I always live in darkness. But yes, we're going to get rid of the human element, because as you can see, me clicking this button and then coming over here to buy an upgrade actually takes time. Look at this. This is precious seconds spent moving over, which isn't spent auto-clicking here. Look, I'm auto-clicking here, and then I have to move over here, auto-click there, auto-click there, auto-click. It takes time. What if we could do away with all of that time entirely? Well, I'm going to go sit down and make myself a quick macro. And what this macro is going to do is press all of these buttons on the side of the screen for us so that we don't have to press them ourselves. One thing I have done is I've used the ad blocker of Opera GX to actually remove the 2 ads that appear on screen here. This is necessary if you're trying to do this exact same setup, because otherwise the adverts are going to get in the way of you actually having more space for more clickers. Because there's cursors, there's grandmas, there's mines, there's more things, there's factories, it just gets more and more and more, more ways of making cookies, and we need to have space for all of them to be clicked. If you had adverts here, you'd have to scroll between them, and that would be a nightmare to try and program on a macro. So I'm gonna go sit down, build ourselves a macro, and I'll show it off to you. Well, here it is, ladies and gentlemen. Say hello to my lovely simple macro. It is absolutely beautiful. It is currently just a very simple 14 action setup. It starts with 4 very quick presses of the cookie right here. Then our mouse immediately comes over here to the store, presses this exact point. Maybe we can purchase it, maybe we can't. Then it immediately starts down at the bottom of this list to the thing that comes after the bank that I can't remember the name of. Then after pressing here, it will go back and press the cookie again. Then it will press the bank. Then it will press the factory, then the cookie. Then it'll buy ourselves a mine. And then it'll do it again just in case, because I had some issues with the mine. Then it'll press the cookie again. Then we'll buy a farm. Then we'll press the cookie again. Then we'll buy a grandmother. And then we'll buy ourselves a cursor. Then we press the cookie and we repeat. Now, this process happens pretty much instantaneously. There is a delay of 1 millisecond between each and every one of these actions, and the script is set to basically repeat indefinitely or until I press Control Numpad 1. This script will just run and look after itself. It can play Cookie Clicker all on its own. And so I want to see just how fast this bad boy can speedrun the entire game. And you know what, ladies and gentlemen, if you've been inspired by all of the clicking that you've been seeing on screen now, you yourself could maybe click the like button and the subscribe button. You see what I did there. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's start our 3rd attempt. Welcome to our 3rd and final factory, Automatic Hell's Bakery, where today we are going to automate the entire process of cookie production. We are going to be pressing this cookie a lot. We are going to be doing a lot of things, but one thing is for certain, this will continue forever. The cookies shall not stop, it shall forever expand and consume and grow, just the way it is intended. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I've got my script ready, I'm going to move it onto my other monitor so it doesn't get in the way, it doesn't accidentally get clicked, and it is now time to begin the legendary cookie clicking. 3, 2, get the timer ready, ladies and gentlemen. 3, 2, 1, liftoff, and we're away. Immediately, we've purchased ourselves our first cursor and our second cursor, and we'll get our 3rd cursor in there as well, a 4th one, lovely stuff. Now, basically, this is a spend all your money kind of setup. We're not trying to actually, you know, efficiently target individual things or maybe save up for an expensive item. No, we are just exclusively buying everything across the board. If we were trying to create a system like that, it would pretty much take weeks and weeks of work to basically just play cookie clicker in the most efficient fashion. And whilst this isn't the most efficient fashion, it is much more efficient than a human being. So we've started off to a pretty good run. We've managed to buy ourselves 13 cursors. We'll be picking up ourselves our first grandma. There we go. Look at her. Isn't she fantastic? She's able to bake one cookie every single second. This is splendid stuff. And soon enough, we'll actually be able to buy ourselves our first actual cursor upgrade. This will be absolutely wonderful for us indeed, as it will basically double all of our production. There we go. Now our clicks are are twice as powerful, and we are making 5 cookies per second. This is a absolutely wonderful start, ladies and gentlemen. Really, really good stuff. Now, we're just past the 2-minute mark, but things are looking quite good. We've got ourselves up to 6 grandmas and 19 curses. We'll make that 20 curses now, meaning we're producing a wonderful 10 cookies per second, as well as our ability to click cookies, which is relatively good. When it comes to us actually clicking cookies, it is at its most efficient quantity, which is probably a decent few cookies per second. Now, we're about halfway to actually buying ourselves our first farm. Cookie production is relatively good. It's up to 17. And we are actually reaching around about the halfway point for the world record, which I do believe sits at just under 7 minutes. Although the world record basically relies on clicking a golden cookie when it appears on screen. This is not something we're going to code in because it's entirely RNG based and not skill based. Whereas this is, okay, not skill based either, but equally, oh God, I just realized that grandma at the top of the screen says she's in indentured servitude. Look, okay, it's not indentured servitude. It's just unpaid endless internship. That's how we like to look at it. Oh, fantastic. Well, we're now to 4 cookies for each click we do of the cookie, which is fantastic. We're making 24.8 cookies per second, which is a wonderful statistic indeed. And honestly, things are looking quite good. All right, we've upgraded the power of grandmas as well, meaning we're making 46.4 cookies per second, which is a wonderful statistic indeed. And there we go, we've just purchased ourselves our first farm, meaning we're up to 54 cookies per second. Lovely stuff. And we're just 6 minutes and 30 seconds now into this run, and things are looking quite good. Our army of grandmothers are growing exceedingly quickly. I don't know where we're able to summon all of these grandmothers from. Maybe we're just rolling around in a van, which is offering free Werther's Originals or something. Now it is 11 minutes and 16 seconds into this run, which means my corgi has broken down my door, but more importantly, we're making 127 cookies per second, which is fantastic. So many cookies, in fact, it has summoned an entire physical corgi. That's how wonderful this is. Progress on the actual system is going relatively well. As we can see, we now have 38 curses, 25 grandmas, and 8 farms. This is wonderful. Splendid progress indeed. But it must continue for hours and hours more. Alright, we've been going for just over 20 minutes. We make 27 cookies per second, which is pretty decent. I'm seeing a nice increase in our growth. We have a total of 16 farms, 32 grandmothers, and 46 curses. Now, I am mostly just interested in when we can get all of the various mouse upgrades, because there are some really good mouse upgrades that will make us very, 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 very profitable and powerful. Chances are we're going to be having to wait at least another 15 or 20 minutes before we start unlocking the upgrades, which allows us to make more than just like 4 or 8 cookies per click, because there are some upgrades that would let us get, say, hundreds of cookies per click, which would be very, very worthwhile. That said, we've just got to continue the wonderful grind. Right, we're 30 minutes in. We're now making around about 836 cookies per second, which is very, very good indeed. Each click now nets us 8 cookies individually, and the process of automation is growing more and more and more. This is fantastic stuff to see. But the process of automation naturally must continue even further. The factory must grow. Alright, some progress has been made. We're now up to making 4,800 cookies per second. We're approaching the 45 minute mark. That's right, I've been here for 3/4 of an hour now, and we are making 4,800 cookies per second. It has been a wonderful experience. Each click now nets us 66.4 cookies. I would make that 67.5 cookies. Because yes, that's right, the more cookies we make per second, the more cookies we gain per click. Basically, the cycle is now going to continue, and we shall gain infinite profit. But naturally, I'm going to go step away, make myself a cup of tea, come back in 50 minutes time, and see vaguely whereabouts we are. Well, we're just about to cross the 1 hour and 15 minute mark, and things are going great. Each click is now 119 cookies. We make just under 10,000 cookies per second. Life is good. The cookies are plentiful. There are now museums dedicated to our cookies. That's how well things are going. Just look at that amazing piece of news. This isn't the end, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, no, 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 no. This is just the beginning. Nothing will stop the progress of my cookie monstrosity. It's pure, perfect efficiency and production rate. We shall conquer the known universe and shower it with cookies. Glorious, endless cookies. All-consuming cookies. Right, and we are now drawing close to the 1 hour and 30 minute mark. And guess what? We now have 15 factories, 32 mines, 49 farms, 66 grandmothers and 80 curses, all culminating in 20,000 cookies per second. Oh my goodness, it's incredible. Now everything is worth about 1 million, so we'll start picking up more and more of these very expensive upgrades, which will increase our cookies per second. But here it is, ladies and gentlemen. In just 5 seconds time, it will now be 1 hour and 30 minutes since I started this. What do I do for a living? What is my job anymore? Oh my god, what even is life? What is meaning? What is happiness? What is joy? Oh, who knows anymore? Who knows? All I know is that I must click and consume the cookies. It is necessary. Well, and this is it, ladies and gentlemen. We have just crossed the 2 hour mark, meaning our adventure into Cookie Clicker has come an incredibly long way. We now make 36,893 cookies per second. This is incredible, but for now, I'm going to actually have to temporarily stop because this is too long. This is incredibly long. I actually have to go and finish some other work today, and I mean, this is wonderful. So come back to this tomorrow and we'll continue this chaos. But for the moment, I'm going to have to quickly end the script as well as this run and this recording. I will be back later. Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. It has been an incredibly long and wonderful time, and we have managed to kind of reach a cookie per second of just underneath 500,000. We're up to 448,000 cookies per second being produced. This is insane. We have an endless fleet of curses, grandmothers, farms, mines, factories, banks, and temples, all mass-producing this cookie and chocolatey goodness. We're starting to reach absurdist levels of cookie production, and I love it. But honestly, the system of entire automation, whilst it means that there's not exactly much work for me, there is one minor issue. And that is that this is exceedingly slow. I know, even though we have an auto clicker running, this game just actually takes a while. And because we're not able to efficiently pick the perks at the top, you know, it's not exactly the most efficient thing. Ooh, look, a golden cookie. Wabam, perfect. But there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We have once again proved that whilst automation is possible, it's not necessarily the greatest move one can make. But hey, if you enjoyed watching us attempt to speedrun Cookie Clicker in the laziest way possible, make sure to absolutely click the ever-living love out of that wonderful like button. And oh my goodness, it would be absolutely amazing if you could also consider subscribing. Oh my goodness. Anyway, as always, thank you very much for watching, you lovely ladies and gentlemen. And if you want to see more videos like this, then hop on down to the comment section and give me a shout. I'd love to try and break more games by creating custom bits of code to completely and utterly decimate their balance. And I'm pretty sure that there's a bajillion games that we can do this for. From injecting SQL into Roblox to doing just about anything, the sky is the limit. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. As always, a huge thank you to each and every one of our majestic patrons who make these videos all the more possible. Seriously, without you, we wouldn't be able to pull something like this off. And if you sat there wondering what video you'd like to watch next, well, look no further than this one on screen now, hand chosen by myself to be absolutely perfect for you. Anyway, I'll see each and every one of you in the next one. Have an absolutely lovely day, and goodbye for now.